Jibbat. Okay, so welcome to the fourth episode of Jibbat Podcast. Our viewers, we have something great lined up for you today. The guest in our studio today is Gaurav Shah, who is a dear friend, and he has a lot of accomplishments that he can credit to himself. He's active as a BNI member. He has recently become a father, so all of you guys can congratulate him.
Thank you.
In the comments. Currently, his biggest achievement would technically be becoming the Rotary President for District 3060, right?
Yes.
What was that all about? How did you contest in an election form or something, or were you selected? What was the process of becoming like the youngest Rotary President?
Thank you, Jaimeen. Thank you for having me today here. Yeah. So basically, Rotary has many of times have elections, and in our club, particularly Rotary Club of Baroda, our club is the oldest club, as you know, Rotary
yes,
Club.
Yes.
Our Rotary Club was affiliated with the second oldest club in India.
Yep.
So yes, I would consider that as an achievement, that I am one of the youngest president of second oldest club of India. But okay, apart from that, it gives me lot of pressure to achieve something great.
Okay.
With this great responsibility, as you know, how with great responsibility comes great, with great powers comes great responsibility.
Yes.
So, yes.
And of course, that transition that you had from Rotaract to Rotary was an extraordinary transition, because both the organizations are completely diametrically opposite. Like, Rotaract is young blood, more youthful events and everything. Rotary is more formalized, it is more systematic. So did you have any problem like merging into your new role as a president in Rotary?
So as Rotaract, in Rotaract clubs, what the best part is, it trains you to become leaders.
Okay.
Now, only becoming leader is not possible without a lot of things what you learn while in the journey.
Yep.
So similar, Rotary has a lot of formalities, as in it has board meetings, it has closed body meetings, it has speaker meets. You do a lot of projects, project planning is done. You make small committees for different projects.
Okay.
So you learn a lot of things out of it. Now, Rotaract's main motto is fellowship through service. And in Rotaract, we don't only follow or do only fellowship, or we not only do only service projects. It is mixture of everything.
Okay.
So basically, Rotaract trains you to become a good leader. And
it teaches you how to speak also. Public speaking is something you learn.
Oh, absolutely. While I was in school, I can imagine myself speaking. Even today, I would be fumbling. But yes, Rotary has taught me a lot of things to be a good to speak anytime, at any point of time, given a topic. Now, that what I've learned from Rotary is absolutely what is the best part about it.
So coming to your role as the Rotary President, because you are one of the youngest presidents, and I'm sure the current Rotarians also realize that there is a shift in trend. Like, people above the age of 45 becoming a president is okay, but when someone who is in the 30s, early 30s age group, and they become the president, everyone else gears up like for quick change. So are you planning to implement any like revolutionary changes in the district or something, like at a policy making level?
So we don't, I am not the only one who changes the policy.
Yeah,
there is a board who decides everything.
Hmm.
But yes, what we are aiming since last 2 or 3 years, we were preparing for this year.
Okay.
As our club is about to reach about 86 years. And now there was a lot of shift in thoughts required.
Okay.
Since a lot of members...
Just for our viewers, he said 86 years. That means the club is older than the country.
Because yes.
It's our 75th Independence
yes.
Day tomorrow.
Yes.
So the club is actually older than the country itself.
Yeah, let me brief you regarding how the club was formed.
Yes, please. We
Maharaja Sayaji Rao went to Chicago.
Okay.
And he saw a Rotary meeting. He attended a Rotary meeting.
Okay.
And with the help of his Diwans,
okay,
they formed the second, that time it was the third oldest club. First was Calcutta,
okay.
Second was Lahore, and third was Baroda.
Pakistan.
Since after the partition, our club became the second oldest.
Yep.
And our Diwan, the Diwan of Baroda city, Baroda district, or the Baroda presidency, was the first president of our club. That is how the club was formed. After that, we have sponsored a lot of clubs around this district.
Yep.
So with this 86 years of heritage, it is a lot of honor for me that I'm president this year. And since we prepared for last 3-4 years for this year, and we want to shift a lot of things, change a lot of things now. We want a lot of young blood to come in the club. We definitely want a lot of your viewers who would like to join the club. We want new energy, new flow coming in.
Definitely.
And lot of things are coming up this year now.
So, in the city of Baroda, I think there are more than 3 Rotaract clubs, right? So, in case our viewers are interested, we'll put a link in the description or something
yes.
for our club's Facebook page.
Yes.
And you can contact the current president and all. So, to give the viewers a brief, Rotary works under an umbrella like an organization. It's a proper organization. There are positions that need to be filled, like treasurers, people who manage the accounts, they are the treasurers. Then there's a president, there are people, other positions, there are
right.
many other positions.
Right.
And they eventually divide all the scope of work amongst them, and they work for not just social activities, but there are 4 pillars, right? There are some 4 pillars which are the scope
right.
of Rotary.
Service avenues.
So there are 4 service avenues, and under them, people end up doing a lot of things, which is good for the society and for the club also.
Yes.
So, one particular aspect which brought me to Rotary is my first contact with Rotary was when I went on a student exchange program.
Yes.
So, could you tell our viewers what the student exchange program is all about under Rotary?
Okay. So, Rotary has a unique program which is called Rotary International Exchange Program. In this exchange program, students from across the globe exchange their countries. For example, students from Baroda would go to France. I have been to France. Jaimeen has been to Germany. And the program has different programs under it.
You went for a long-term
program.
Long-term
program.
Which was like a one-year
program. One-year program. So, longest is 1 year.
Yeah.
After that, it is 3 months and 1 month.
One
so,
month.
Different programs for different kind of students. In this exchange program, you learn a lot of, so basic was cultural exchange. Rotary wanted
yeah.
to promote cultural exchange.
Yes.
So if I go and stay in France, so example, if I'm going to Paris, I would just stay in hotel and come back. That would be
yeah.
like a tourist.
Yes.
But when you're going as a student exchange, you would actually stay with French families. Stayed with 3 French families. Each of them were from different fields. One of was lawyer, one was dentist, one was professor. And you actually stay in their house. This is something amazing that you would never imagine. What would you like before I went there? So I'll brief about my story also how
yes.
this came up.
Yes.
Before me, from my father's club, there was nobody who went for a long-term exchange.
Okay.
Everybody was like, "Ah, to varas bagde, varas jature, pachi pachu awanu ne, school ma pachu join thawanu." So my father was like, "Nah, if you are going for a 3 month, it is like a holiday that you can do any time in your life.
Yes.
But if you go for a year, you would not get something like this after once you are about, you know, you become adult." So at the age of
most people have this thinking that ek saal bigdega,
ek saal
bigdega,
yes.
that, which is complete nonsense because
yes.
wo ek saal mein jo tum seekhte ho. No education institute
yes.
can like provide that to you. Yeah.
So lot of things happen on an exchange. For a year, you get lot of times when you are isolated, when you are alone.
Yes.
That also teaches you lot of things.
Yep.
You find lot of new friends. So as of now, I have about 27 different friends in across the world.
Okay.
So if I am going to Mexico, I have somebody who would pick up from the airport and take me around in Mexico. That connections we built in exchange.
Okay.
Apart from that, food, you try different food. I was vegetarian by choice. So while going to France, one of the main issue was how would I survive with no food habits there.
Food habits.
But then my families were so good that they would prepare a lot of food. In fact, one of my host mother downloaded a complete Gujarati food recipe book.
Okay.
And she would make Gujarati food in France.
In
so
France.
You can imagine a French
exactly.
lady cooking Gujarati food. Yes.
So I went for a short term exchange, right? It was, I think, NGSE. That's
yes.
what the exchange is
yes.
called. New Generation
exchange program.
Service Exchange. So my exchange was, I think, 21 days, and then we extended it for 9 days traveling around
right.
Europe. And while I was in Germany, one thing that I saw, our host mother, shout out to Krista if you are seeing this. my host mother had a cabinet in her kitchen, which was called Indian masala cabinet. And she had everything, like, right from chole masala to masala,
garam masala, and everything.
All masalas in her cabinet because she was very fond of the Indian cuisine.
Yes.
And she has hosted, I think, over 20 students in the entire exchange history
yes.
at her house independently. So some such thing, and it is very sad that currently Rotary is not doing the exchange, right?
In fact, my host mother, after 12 years, she is still using chaat masala for her food.
Okay.
So you can imagine French food having chaat masala.
Chaat masala, that is like croissant with chaat masala.
Croissant with
chaat masala. That is great. Yeah. Now, did you pick up French when you were there? Like, you picked up French also?
I gave third level exam. So,
okay.
I'm third level qualified French now.
Okay. And you can write and read both?
Yeah, everything.
Great, man. That is great. So, that is what student exchanges give you, right?
Yes.
And you did this after your 12th grade, if I'm not wrong.
So, I finished my 12th. One fine day, daddy said, said, okay. And in fact, the main problem about exchanges, there is a lot of fear in you.
Yeah.
Like if you have seen in our 12th standard, 11th standard, we have been on 11th and we just follow everyone.
Yeah.
Like chalo aaj khawa jo, everybody starts going to the same place.
Yes.
You want to change school, let's change school together. College, mm-hmm. engineering, everybody goes to engineering.
Yeah.
Similarly, I followed my friends, everybody said engineering, I said engineering.
Engineering.
I went to engineering college.
Mm.
In that fear that if I am not with them, I'll miss everything in my life.
Yes.
So one fine day when this happened, daddy said, "Jawanon se long time." I said, "Chalo, let's try." When I was in my college, one fine day in the afternoon, I got a call that my visas were rejected for the first time.
Okay.
Since I was turning 18 in France.
Okay.
And on Wednesday.
I remember you were that one kid who had his birthday, 18th birthday
in France.
In France.
Yes.
So you were technically just qualifying to go on an exchange at 18, right?
Yes.
That story must be interesting. So, go carry on. Bro.
Yes. So, visas were rejected. You see, the power of Rotary here is that we contacted the Rotarians here.
Hmm.
They contacted Rotarians in France.
Okay.
And France Rotarians contacted the embassy, French embassy, Indian embassy in France.
Okay.
They granted me visa and I got a call from French embassy. Come tomorrow to our embassy.
Okay.
You have been granted visa, and I was given red carpet. I went there. It took hardly 5 minutes. I came out with the visa. And you see, you go alone. You don't have anyone coming with you in the embassy.
Yeah.
At the age of 18, you have a lot of fears.
Big deal. That's a big
and they would not speak in English.
Yeah.
Being a French country, they would.
Parler au français.
Yes. Only French.
Only French.
On ne parle pas anglais. So. So that happened. Then in the college, I was sitting outside, and daddy called that kale visa mate jawan ho ja.
Okay.
So Thursday we went to Bombay for visa. That time flights were not that appropriate, so we went by train. Morning we went by Shatabdi. We reached Bombay.
Okay.
I took visa in the afternoon. So on the weekend there was the exchange cultural program where every exchange student was meeting for the first time.
Okay.
So
that happens. I think they try to organize one
for everyone.
Everyone.
So that is it. You have to go there because you'll meet everyone or you'll miss this.
Yes.
So he said, let's do one thing. They are meeting on Friday.
Hmm.
You reach there on Saturday.
Okay.
So this was Thursday.
Hmm.
Next day was when Friday. And I was supposed to reach there on Saturday. I said, Daddy, I'm friends. I'm going to go. He said, Tyadi phone kar lete.
Just go.
Why do you want to miss this thing?
Hmm. Hmm.
And I said, but college has not accepted my, in fact, that was the first year of Gujarat Technical University, GTU.
Okay.
So they didn't have any clause for drop case. It was only pass or fail.
Yeah.
But you cannot take a drop.
Yeah, you cannot take a drop. Like you get 1 month break,
you cannot take
break, break.
No breaks are allowed. You just fail.
Yeah.
So I went to college. They said, break? Eto su hai, drop le ono itle. Ame to khali detain kariye cha.
Hmm.
Because I'm coming back after 1 year. So you need to reserve my seat and I'll come back. And
did they
said, go to GTU.
Okay.
So I went to Gandhinagar. Gandhinagar, they said, our officer shifted to LD college.
Okay.
So I went there.
Okay.
And then table after table. And then I said, Daddy, this is not possible.
Hmm.
I don't think without permission I should go.
Hmm.
He said, what will happen? Just go. Come back after 1 month if they say no.
That is something great that your dad has done.
Yes.
Most fathers in India would not support a thing like this. They'll be like, oh, education reh jayega.
Yes.
But because your dad supported, you have this experience and this story to share today, which is a great thing. Shout out to uncle. If
he said one thing that one, you're not wasting, you're investing in your life.
Yes, 100%.
This will absolutely, you have 80, 90 years to live, and 1 year if you spend somewhere out of country, that will teach you a lot of things in life.
Tell me honestly, bro, when you were in France for that 1 year, how many new things did you learn every day?
Every day was a new thing.
Exactly.
Going to a shop, shopkeeper speaking with you in French was a new thing for me.
Yes.
You're going to a shop, you're buying bread, even small bread, like bread we have only seen in bags.
Yes.
They would sell it on the floor, it is on
open
the table.
Yeah,
you just open and
it.
You buy, take it and keep it in your car.
Yep.
That was new thing. Illegally,
so many,
illegally I drove a car for 1 minute, just to say that I drove a car in France. So,
okay,
lot of things absolutely were new. Traveling alone, I missed my bus. Mm-hmm. I missed my stop. I would take wrong buses. Yeah. I would end up... So, our city was on the north side of France.
So, at this point, since you mentioned driving, we can mention the four D's, right?
Yes.
And there's the fifth D.
Yes.
So, in Rotary, there are four D's basically. You don't drink, you don't drive.
Don't date.
Don't date and no drugs. Do drugs. But there's a fifth D, which is unofficial, which only Rotaractors who have gone on an exchange know about. And that D is...
Never get caught.
Don't get caught. Exactly. So, that's the story behind Rotary, man. And it's a great thing. We had this amazing experience. You had it for 1 year, I went for just a month, but still it was so
absolutely different.
It was amazing, right? Okay, so Gaurav, coming back to the exchanges, man, like what would be those unique moments that you shared during the exchanges? I think we have a photo library, you know, which we can talk about.
I can definitely share one of the photos.
Yes, yes,
which
yes.
Which is very close to me.
Okay.
So, one of this photo is the first photo.
Okay.
This is the same day, this is the Saturday when I reached there.
Okay, France.
Completely sleeping, but okay. I wanted to meet all these 27 friends.
Okay.
And that is the reason I did all this, of reaching there early.
Guy sleeping.
Oh, this is at about 4 a.m. in the morning.
Oh, this is 4 a.m. in the morning. And where are you? This is you, right?
That is me, yes.
Oh, epic, bro. And there are people from all the countries,
all countries
that you could possibly
all find. Countries. I can see, so Australia, Canada, China,
flags,
America, Mexico, so different friends from
everywhere. From everywhere. And why does Rotary do this? They they have a particular student meet kind of thing that happens. Right?
Yes,
on
yes. On
what is it called?
Once every year, there are two times when all the exchange students meet.
Okay.
So this was our district which was meeting. There was second meet where all the exchange students of France were meeting.
Okay.
This happens only in three years.
Okay.
And that is the year where. When I was there, that also happened in Toulouse.
Okay.
So we took a
Toulouse.
Bus.
Toulouse is a party destination right
yes.
now. It's a party island
okay.
right now. Epic.
So from the north of France, we took a bus and went to the south. All
okay.
the 27 exchange students in a single bus.
Okay.
So that was a complete different experience on
okay.
a bus. You did a bus trip to south of France.
Okay.
One of this picture is very close to me.
Okay. Yes, and it's Independence Day. Jai Hind to you, man.
Jai
Hind.
So
we are going to air this episode on Independence Day. It's Independence Day tomorrow.
Great.
So for our viewers, it's today. And you are holding an Indian flag, which is...
So, at the Toulouse conference, we had about 500 exchange students from across the world.
Okay.
And 500. And I was given an opportunity to raise our Indian flag.
Okay.
And national anthem was played. And that at that moment, at that point of time, while holding the flag, the experience what I had was completely different because you were raising the flag in front of exchange students from different countries.
Like
you must
500
have,
students, that means mostly
yes,
all countries.
All countries.
All
you
countries.
Must have always done in front of Indians.
Yeah.
But you have never got an opportunity to do it in front of different countries.
Goosebumps aa jaye, bro. Goosebumps aa
jaye.
If you do it in front of a non-Indian crowd,
it
you would definitely have a
feel.
Patriotic surge in you, man.
So this photo
is
amazing, one of the photo which absolutely I discuss this about everywhere, whatever orientations or conferences I have.
How was the feeling, man, when the national anthem played behind you and you had the flag in your hand standing in front of all those
out of the world.
It's
absolutely out of the world.
I can imagine. And what are all these buttons on your jacket? They are
so all the exchange students would exchange their pins.
Okay.
We take our pins from here.
Okay.
And we exchange with each and every exchange student and we put it on our blazer.
Okay.
So this blazer I've made a photo frame on my room.
Okay.
And every day it reminds me of all the opportunities, all different kind of people I've met across
amazing.
The complete year. It has all different kinds of pins. Even I have collected champagne capsules, champagne
corks.
Corks.
Okay, corks.
And that also is on my blazer. So
okay.
small things reminds me of small memories.
Great. We are going to plug in this picture of this blazer for our viewers to
sure.
see. It is epic, bro. And you literally like frame the blazer and
yes,
put it up on your wall.
Yes.
As a reminder.
As a reminder, it reminds me every day of what I've accomplished till now.
How quickly do you think the exchanges are going to resume after this COVID crisis?
So looking at current scenario, it stopped due to COVID.
Yeah.
And as you know, the travel challenges, how completely it is difficult right now.
Totally.
And I don't know until everything gets completely normalized in the world. I'm not sure when it will start. Even the flight details.
Have you heard about Canada? The thing that is
yes.
going on with Canada. It is so weird,
yes.
man. Like all the routes that they have started. So for our viewers, Canada is not allowing Indian students directly
to fly
into Canada. So our travel agent community, because we live in a country like India, they have created a unique system where they are bypassing international laws, probably using the biggest loophole ever. So what they are doing is, they are, you know about this, right?
Yes.
So they are flying people from India to
Maldives.
Maldives, you get a RT-PCR done for 3 days, you stay there for 3 days, and then you fly to either Cairo, Ukraine, Athens, Greece. So all these places which Canada would never suspect an Indian to come from. Like, which Canadian embassy would be expecting an Indian dude from Anand or I don't know, somewhere
Baroda
to walk into Pearson Airport from like Greece or say
yes.
Ukraine. I would be scared to go to Ukraine, man. If you got a chance, like if you had to reach Canada in like say 5 days from now, and it must be taking time also. How
absolutely
much time
5 to 6 days is minimum time what each and every student is taking right now to reach there.
So, and all those 5 to 6 days, you are practically just transiting through airports. Stuff, right?
Or you're staying in hotels.
Or staying
in fact,
hotels.
Recent news is Maldives hotels are filled with Indian students. I don't want to make it public, but yes, that is
the truth
right now.
So, Maldivian government, this is great. You have helped us, our travel agent industry, with a loophole. Thank you. For our viewers, Maldives government did not sponsor this video. They had nothing to do with this video, of course. But I wish they would someday sponsor this.
Maybe, why not?
You never know. And but yeah, they are doing a great thing. So what do students do, man? Once they go to Maldives, they stay in like a hotel for 3 days.
I mean, as far as I know, Maldives is a couple friendly place. And
I don't know
how romantic each and every student would be. So you can imagine staying in a hotel in Maldives and doing nothing.
Yeah, practically that. And I don't know, would you be comfortable going to a country like Ukraine, man? If you had to go to Canada like in 7 days.
If I have to go to Canada for studying, I would not prefer going to Ukraine.
Yeah.
But if I had to go there for a visit, yes, definitely I would visit Ukraine once.
Okay.
But not for this route, bypassing this law right now.
Okay. But I think it's a big loophole, right? What if Canada some finds out about this and decides to like cut this route midway and everyone with an Indian passport can't travel or something like that?
I don't think they would do, because each and every student is coming with a revenue.
Okay.
If you see as
their entire economy depends on us, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I think so. That is the case.
So I don't think until everybody is safe with COVID, I don't think they would stop.
I heard about this area in Toronto, which is Brampton or something, which is called Mini Punjab.
Mini Punjab.
People
yeah.
call it like Brampton because it's Punjabi, man. So
I don't think only Punjab is there. Gujarati is also everywhere in Toronto now.
Okay.
So
it's great.
Filled
man.
With Gujaratis.
It's sad how many. I think Canada is like the Noah's Ark. So once everyone migrates to Canada, like the entire world population will be disposable. Like
only in Canada.
Do anything. Like do nuclear tests in Africa. I don't care. Throw a disease in India like COVID-19. But that's
oh,
a
I still have good friends from Canada.
Okay.
On my exchange, I had, in fact, I
think Canada has a francophonic part, right? Like
just while we were talking, I have a photo of a friend who's from Canada.
Okay, the girl in the
red. Yeah, so I would not criticize that part, but
okay.
Yeah, it is absolutely political, which we cannot decide right now.
Yeah, and we are too inconsequential.
Yes.
I don't think this podcast is going to blow up that much that Canada
yes.
government sees this. So again, for our viewers, Canada government
did
not sponsor this podcast, but someday they might. And that's what the hope is here. So great, man. What else would you want to share about your experiences? Like, how was the convocation? You have a proper coronation ceremony for every president, right? Like, once you become a president, there's a full.
I would
it's
start.
It's not a convocation, right?
No,
it's
it is just an installation.
Else. Installation, yeah.
But before going that, I would take back little bit on the Rotaract part.
Yeah, yes.
After the exchange program, I and one of my dear friend Ayan, you know.
Yes.
We thought of starting Rotex. Rotex is a club which is for past exchange students.
Okay.
And that orients new exchange students and promotes exchange program.
Yes.
We did 2 or 3 meetings and then somebody said, why don't you start Rotaract?
Hmm.
We said, okay, let's start Rotaract.
Okay.
So, very first meeting, it was us.
You were the founding
secretary.
Secretary of Rotaract Club
Baroda.
Of Vadodara, which
yes.
is great. That club is doing something amazing, man. Like the kind of events we did for social work and everything, it was par excellence. Yeah, so carry on.
In fact, our club has sponsored a lot of leaders.
Okay.
Now, if you see, everybody is moved out of India.
Okay.
That is something phenomenal that they are leaders in their own profession now.
Yeah.
And So we started Rotaract. We saw a lot of initial meetings where it was only me and Ayan sitting there at the Rotary Hall and killing mosquitoes.
Okay.
And then we figured that we need to do something extraordinary to get crowd.
Okay.
So my personal goal or aim in life is, if I do something, I want to make it the best. I want to be number one in whatever I do.
Yes.
So we started taking up events. We started doing small blood donation camps, and at the age of 18, we could gather about 80 to 100 donors.
Okay.
At the first go. So that was something trip changing.
Exceptional.
Then we started doing treasure hunts, and treasure hunt, we saw footfall of about 120 participants coming in.
Yes, I remember Rota treasure hunt was a big event.
Yes,
in town.
Yes, yes, that time it was great event. We did tracks to Pavagarh.
Okay.
We took about 200 Rotaractors from across district to Pavagarh.
Yes.
And that we continued for about 3 to 4 years in a row.
4 or 5 seasons, you
know? Yes.
It was called Rotaract.
Rotaract.
We are going to put an image of that too.
Yes,
to
yes. See. So, all these things lead to something very different in my life. I never imagined after 3 years of being in Rotaract, I would be given an opportunity to become DRR.
Okay.
Now, DRR is somebody who is... it is district Rotaract representative.
Yes.
And he represents complete Rotaract district.
Mm-hmm.
And I had about 45 clubs under me.
Okay.
So that was a great opportunity, a big opportunity which I got, and I took it. I was selected to become the DRR. There is one picture of me being collared the DRR.
Okay.
And that was my first picture with the collar. This collar is utmost importance to me.
You must have preserved it at home, kept it very...
This is my first speech as DRR.
Okay.
While giving the speech, you can imagine how... And this was in the auditorium with the audience of about 400, 500 Rotarians.
Oh.
And that was pretty scary, and yeah, things happened.
Rotarians change the air of the room like instantly.
Yes.
As long as Rotaractors are gathered in a room, the environment is light and calm.
Yes.
But as soon as Rotarians walk in, it
changes.
Becomes serious, and it becomes more professional.
Yes.
Oriented.
While I was the DRR, district Rotaract representative,
okay.
I had been to Kenya.
Okay.
And there was a district conference, and I was invited
in
at the conference for
okay.
Kenya, and as an ambassador, as a guest,
okay.
They called me there. That was also one of the things which reminds me of my DRR.
So
year.
Rotary is an organization which is all across the world.
All across the
all
world.
Across
yeah.
the world. And these are the Kenyan Rotarians that you
met. Now Rotarians.
Now
that Rotary. Time they were Rotaractors.
Okay.
So great opportunity that time also.
I also had this excursion. So when I went to Melbourne, I tried to contact the Rotaract Club of Melbourne in Australia, and they invited me for a flyer distribution program in the Central Business District and all.
Huh.
So that was also a good experience.
Amazing
we
experience.
Eventually just distributed flyers to everyone.
Yes.
I think the flyers were about supporting the homeless for
okay.
some initiative.
Okay.
And it was a great thing.
I'll continue with the
yes.
Rotaract part. And so 1 year changes you completely because you're dealing with about 600. That time it was about 1500 Rotaractors.
Okay.
You see a lot of new members coming in, you have a lot of different ideas coming in.
Mm.
And that also changed me a lot of inside me, because you start considering or you start thinking as how would you become a good leader out of it.
Okay.
How would you take all everybody's idea in your program and make it a big program?
Yes, why not?
So that changed me completely. There's this last picture which I always keep it as my wallpaper.
Okay.
which I kissed my DRR scholar before giving it to the next DRR.
Yes.
Yes.
But being the DRR is something you hold very dearly.
Dear to my heart. And that lead to me becoming the president of the oldest club of Rotary Club of Baroda.
Okay.
So
that
was
the foundation pillar.
For
and your journey is still going on. So we'll probably do a part 2 for your presidentship. Like after you complete the entire tenure for your
yes.
presidentship, we are going to talk about it with pictures and your journey.
Yes.
How was it all about? So how did you like this concept of this podcast? So the format of this podcast is basically, it's not like an interview. I can't have people sitting there who want to be interviewed.
Right.
Because that's not, it's not an interview, right? A podcast
right.
is where you have an open discussion like the one we just had.
Yes.
So it's great. So are you excited? If in your term the exchanges open up again, what would be that one change that you would incorporate from your end? Would there be anything new that you would try?
So the complete Rotary program is everything very well organized.
Yes.
There are a lot of good orientation programs happening. So even for somebody who's very new to Rotary or very new to exchange program, I'm absolutely sure that everything is completely well defined. There is not anything which I would like to personally change, but yes, definitely I would personally give my 100% to upcoming exchange programs or students who would want to go on an exchange.
Okay, so what I want to tell our viewers at this time is that Rotary Club of Vadodara is ready to accept new applicants each year. You can become a member. It's a social activity. Social media is practically robbing us of the fundamental human nature, where we need to meet in a community of people,
yes,
talk to each other, have that personal connect. All that has completely been washed off by Facebook, Insta, Snapchat, whatever you want to say. And Rotary Club of Vadodara and clubs under the Rotary banner, no matter where you are watching this from, it might be somewhere in Pune,
right,
or Bangalore.
Anywhere.
Joining a Rotary club will be fundamentally changing your life completely to an extent I can't even begin to tell you, because it's an experience you'll have to experience on your own self.
Yes, it cannot be put on paper.
It cannot be put on paper. There is no set way to do it. Okay, so with that, we can end our podcast here. If you want to have any concluding statements, you can give them to us right now.
No, there's just one thing that we need to be out of our fear.
Yes.
One thing what I have learned from my past few experiences, no matter what you do, whatever you do, never have fear of anything. Just go and do it.
Okay, so Gaurav, thank you for being on the show. Our title sponsor, the people who have formed this team, are organized by this entity called Pac-Man Bespoke Gifting, and they have a hamper for you right now. And you have to open the hamper right now for this podcast.
Thank you so much.
So have a look inside. It's a great concept. This company has been started in Baroda.
Bag looks something different.
Yes. So the bag is made out of seed paper. I think it's seed paper. So once you are done with the bag, if you put it in a plant or just plant it somewhere, it will become a tree or a plant.
Oh.
So this is under the Pac-Man's Green Initiative. They have a lot of stationery items which have pencils with seeds in them. So eventually when you are done with the pencil, you just plant it. So everything
this book
is
also something different.
Yes,
that is also the
seed paper. Yeah, all this is the eco-friendly range. The good thing about Pac-Man is that they have a lot of products which you can create into hampers.
Okay.
So I personally, when it was my cousin's wedding, I gave her a hamper which included a lot of things, like a Bluetooth speaker, coffee, like imported coffee, chocolates, everything. So, and the best part is they have a back-end office which is available 24/7. So you just call on that number.
Okay.
The number is in the description for our viewers in case you want to see it. You just call them, give them a budget, tell them you have a budget of 10k, 5k, it's a birthday, 2k, 5k, whatever. And they'll just make a customized hamper for you and deliver it to your doorstep.
Great.
It's the latest innovation in like customized gifting, and they are our title sponsors also. So, and we are very proudly associated with them.
Thank you so much for this.
Yes.
I'll definitely 100% use it.
Yep.
Thank you, Pac-Man also.
Yep.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much.